This time last year, our school was hanging in the balance. But look at us now. We're here, we're ready to go, we're having a great year. We're going to be soaring to new heights. So one big round of applause from Buckholts ISD. What we're going to do. Christmas is a wonderful time of year. It is the time of year that most people give gifts to their loved ones. But might I suggest that we step back from the materialistic point of view and focus on the real meaning of Christmas. Christmas is a time to reflect on our love for others and to search for ways that we can spread our love even more. It is a time to focus on, with thankful hearts, all of our blessings that we are blessed with every day. No matter the lot in our life, we all have something to be thankful for. After all, we have each other. And in true Badger style, we will get on with the show. It's going to be the Christmas reading by Mr. Gabriel Owens and Kenneth Shelton and Isaac Albert. I'm so sorry, I'm a feeling right now. And Juan Melendez. Guys, come on out. Oh, they're so good looking. Look at them. Our little elves and our reindeer. All right. Here you go, guys. Let me give you this.
Dickens referred to his story as a carol. Usually a carol is a song like the two Christmas carols that follow. The first is a traditional carol that was popular in Dickens' time. The second was written during the Civil War, The Black Accursed Mouth, that Longfellow describes as the mouth of a cannon on the battlefield. Good King Whistles, good King Whistles, looked out on the feast of Stephen when the snow lay around the belt, deep and crisp and even.
Brightly shone the moon that night, though the frost was cruel, when a poor man came in sight, gathering winter fuel.
Hither, page, and stand by me, if thou knowest the tale. Yonder peasant, who is he, where and what is dwelling?
Sigh, he leaves a goodly kiss underneath the mountain, right against the forest fence by St. Agnes Fountain. Bring me flesh, and bring me wine, bring me pine logs, hither. Thou and I shall see him die, and when we bear them thither.
Page and monarch forth they went together, though the rude winds wild lament and the bitter weather.
Sire, the night is darker now, and the wind grows stronger. Fills my heart, I know not how, I can go no longer.
Mark my footsteps, my good page, tread thou in them boldly. Thou shalt find the winter's rage freezing thy bloodlust coldly.
In his master's steps he trod, where the snow lay tinted. He was in the very sod which the saint had printed. Therefore, Christian men, be sure, wealth or rank possessing, ye who now bless the poor shall yourselves find blessing.
Christmas Day, their old, severe carols play, and the wild and sweet, the words repeat, on peace on earth, goodwill to men.
And thought how, as the day had come, the belfries of Christendom, he rolled along the unbroken song, of peace on earth, goodwill to men.
Till ringing, singing on its way, the world revolved from night to day, a voice, a chime, a chant sublime, of peace on earth, goodwill to men.
Then from each black accursed mouth, the cannon thundered in the south. And with the sound, the carols drowned of peace on earth, goodwill to men.
It was as if an earthquake rent the hearthstones of a continent and made forlorn the households born of peace on earth, goodwill to men.
And in despair, I bowed my head. There is no peace on earth, I said, for hate is strong. The mocks a song of peace on earth, goodwill to men.
The peal of the bells more loud and deep. God is not dead, nor doubt he sleep. The wrong shall fail, the right prevail. With peace on earth, goodwill to men.
Thank you, gentlemen. Very good job. Next, we're going to have a very, very special entertainment by Mr. Jimmy Cox as he does the Scrooge test. We are going to take a Scrooge test. Now, you may be a Scrooge if you always walk bent over to look for change dropped in the snow. Or you make fun of anyone wearing red or green. That would be me. You still answer the door by asking visitors, "What did you bring me?" You enjoy telling children there is no Santa Claus, or you throw water balloons at Christmas carolers. You have a t-shirt that says, "Money can buy happiness." You pack your snowballs with ice. That would be some of my students. You consider Ebenezer Scrooge and Jacob Marley your true role models. You think Bob Cratchit was a whiner. You think Tiny Tim was faking it. Your favorite phrase is "Bah humbug." And your rotten disposition never takes a holiday.
Good evening. Early Merry Christmas and Feliz Navidad. Thank you for being here tonight. My name is Mrs. Sabol. I teach the pre-K and kinder classroom. We will be singing the first two songs for you this evening, Jingle Bells, and All I Want for Christmas is My Two Front Teeth. Will you please give them a warm round of applause?
Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. All the time is to ride one more song. Matthew Nunn, and I'll be reading 12th Night Before Christmas. children were all nestled, all snug in their beds, while visions of sugar plums danced in their heads. And Mama in her kerchief, and I and my cat had just settled our brains for a long winter's nap. When out on the lawn there arose such a clatter, I sprang from my bed to see what was the matter. Away to the window I flew like a flash, threw open the shutters and flew up the sash. The moon on the bright with the of the new fallen snow gave a luster of midday to objects below. When up to what to my wondering eyes did appear but a miniature sleigh, a tiny reindeer, with the little old driver, and so lively and quick, I knew in a moment he must be thinking. The rapids and eagle, his courses they came, and he whistled and shouted and called them by name. Now Dasher, now Dancer, now Prancer and Vixen, on Comet, on Cupid, on Donner and Blitzen, to the top of the porch, to the top of the wall, now dash away, dash away, dash away all. As leaves that before the wild hurricane fly, when they meet with an obstacle, mount to the sky. So up to the housetop they courteously flew, with a sleigh full of toys and safe needles too. And then in twinkling I heard on the roof, prancing and pawing of each little hoof. As I drew in my head and was turning around, down the chimney St. Nicholas came with a bound. He was dressed all in fur, from his head to his foot, and his clothes were all tarnished with ashes and soot. A bundle of toys he had flung on his back, and he looked like a peddler just opening his pack. His eyes had a twinkle, his dimples how merry. His cheeks were like roses, his nose like a cherry, his nose like a cherry. His droll little mouth was drawn up like a bow. And the beard on his chin was as white as the snow. Of a pipe he held tight in his teeth, and his coat encircled his head like a wreath. He had a broad face and a little round belly that shook when he laughed like a bowl full of jelly. He was totally and plump, a right jolly old elf. And I laughed when I saw him in spite of myself. A wink of his eye and a twist of his head soon gave me to know I had nothing to dread. He spoke not a word, but went straight to his work. He filled up all the stockings and turned with a jerk, and laying his fingers beside his nose, and giving a nod of the chimney, he rose. He sprang to his sleigh, to his team he gave a whistle, and away they flew like down the down of a thistle. But I heard him exclaim, he dove out, rose out of sight. Happy Christmas all, and to all a good night.
Mr. Nunn, that was such a fantastic job. Thank you so much. Let's give him another round of applause.
Hello, I'm Mrs. Bridges, and I am the third grade teacher. I'm very proud of it. And I'm proud of my students, and thank you, Matthew. Tonight, our third grader will be performing the 12 Days of Christmas Vacation. And also, I want a hippopotamus for Christmas. Thank you.
And a coupon for a bunch in my room. cabbage soup, two cookies. And for one girl, don't clean my room.
On the sixth day of Christmas, my mother gives you me six silly stickers. Five long days of four empty bedrooms.
Three shallow shoes. Two curly cookies.
And a coupon for a room to clean my room. On the second day of Christmas, my mother gave to me seven pocket puppets. Six silly stickers.
Three shall we shoot? Two
curly cookies. And a coupon for a room to clean my room.
Oh,
Alright, and now for your humor senses. Not me this time, guys, so give it up for Mr. Ralston and Mr. Mars.
Did you know Santa had only 8 reindeer last Christmas?
What?
Thomas stayed home to clean the sink. What did the reindeer say to the football player?
I don't know.
Your blitzing days are over. How did the sheep say Merry Christmas?
Cow.
Leaf Navidad. Where do snowmen keep their money?
Me too.
In a snow bag. What's the difference between Santa's reindeer and a knight?
What?
One slaying the dragon and the other one dragging his legs.
Hello, I am Miss Mejia and I teach the fourth grade. Tonight our class will be honoring the servicemen and women with some patriotic tunes. Please feel free to sing along, especially when they sing the Star Spangled Banner. At this time, I would like to have our service men and women who have served our country to please stand so we may thank you for our service. We now have the open mentors from the Mighty Badger football team will perform This Land Is Your Land, It's a Grand Old Flag, and Star Spangled Banner.
Soldier. Was this the hero of whom I just read, curled up on a poncho, the floor for a bed? Then I realized the other families that I saw this night owed their lives to soldiers who were willing to fight. In the morning round the world, children would play. Grown-ups would celebrate a bright Christmas day. They all enjoy freedom each month of the year because of soldiers like the one lying here. I couldn't help but wonder how many lay alone on a cold Christmas Eve in lands far from home. The very thought put a tear to my eye. I dropped to my knees. I started to cry. A soldier awakened. I heard his rough voice. Santa, don't cry. This life is my choice. I fight for freedom. I don't ask for more. My life is my God, my country, my core. The soldier rolled over and drifted asleep. but I couldn't control it, and I continued to weep. I kept watch for hours, so silent and still, as both of us shivered from the cold night's chill. I didn't want to leave him on that cold, dark night, this guardian of honor, so willing to fight. Then the soldier rolled over, and a voice soft and pure, he whispered, "Carry on, Santa. It's Christmas Day, all secure." One look at my watch, I knew he was right. Merry Christmas, my friend. May God bless you this night.
Yes, the ocean. But my fans.
I said sit.
Well, if you put it that way, is something the matter?
The matter? Ho, ho, ho. Don't we always talk before Christmas exhibition?
But we've done it so many times.
Just humor me, Your Highness. I like the reviewer, Rob.
Hey, Santa, can I take some photos for the North Pole Daily Times?
Of course. Who said you think's my best?
Sorry, Santa. I'll get some shots of you later. Rudolph is our lead story. These would be perfect. Would you sign an autograph for my sister?
I'd be delighted. What is going on here?
Sorry, Santa. I'll be out of your hair in just a moment. Thanks, Rudy.
Don't mention it.
Later, I promise. Sorry for interrupting. Good luck tonight.
Now let's review our procedures.
It's my Santa. Yeah, tell the Girl Scouts I'll be there later. Now you were saying?
Never mind, there's something more urgent to discuss. A young, experienced fan cut your head like bubbles in a cold glass of Coca-Cola.
Last year without me, there would have been no Christmas.
So the fifth graders are going to do Rockin' Around the Christmas Tree and Grandma Got Run Over by a Reindeer.
Walking Excitement? Are you anticipating being with family and friends? Or is this season only a job that'll be over in a week or so? Only a job sounds sad, doesn't it? I mean, none of us ever started out thinking of Christmas as only a job, did we? No, surely not. There was passion and anticipation and joy welling up inside of us till we didn't think we could celebrate the birth of Jesus Christ any longer. Well, somewhere along the way this evening, we are going to look at Christmas, not from a human standpoint, but from an angelic standpoint. Oh no, not the heavenly ones, but how about just for fun, of course, we look at Christmas from the standpoint of treetop angels. Those that are placed on the very top of Christmas trees all over the world. Surely from their place of honor, they would never describe Christmas as only a job, or would they?
Gabby, is that you?
Yes, I'm Gabby. Why, who are you?
Wait a minute. Melody, is that you?
Yes, how are you?
I'm fine. You look a little, messed up.
Well, Gabby, you know I've been a treetop angel.
A
20 years now.
Me too. I actually just finished my 18th year. And let me tell you all about it. I'm just about ready to hang it up.
Tell me about it. You know, I feel the same way. Matter of fact, I think this is my last year.
Oh no, really?
What's wrong with you?
What do you mean?
You've got that twitching thing going on there. What's that all about?
Oh, well I was working on a Christmas tree out at the mall.
Well, that doesn't sound so bad.
Well, actually, the job wasn't so bad until...
It's okay, just get a grip and tell me what happened.
Bubba happened.
What?
Bubba. And he's not a what, he's a who. He's a little kid that came to the mall every day. And I mean every day. And threw gummy bears all over me when his mother wasn't looking.
Oh, yeah. I think I see one.
Ouch. Thanks anyways. His mom kept screaming, Bubba, where are you? Bubba, come over here. Bubba, you better get over here before I count to three. But she never, never came to get him. I think I hear him coming now.
No, he's not here. You're safe, I promise.
Are you sure?
Positive. Now, Ben, just tell me what happened. Oh, now settle down.
Okay, let's talk about something else. Talking about Bubba makes me crazy. What's that thing you're holding?
Well, you see, it used to be attached to my back, you know, to hold me on the tree.
Yeah, why isn't it attached anymore? Did you fall off the tree and break?
Well, actually, I wish that simple, but it's kind of a long story.
Well, the more we talk about you, the less I have to think about Bubba.
Well, but you have to promise not to tell anyone. It's really a weird little story.
Okay, I promise.
Well, up to last year, I used to work out the trees at the mall too, just like you. But then I decided I wanted to be an angel on a nice little tree, a nice little house with a nice little family.
Well, that doesn't sound so bad, unless you were assigned to Bubba's family.
No, actually, I was assigned to the Shaver family.
The Shaver family? Don't you mean the principal's family?
That's the one.
Well, that doesn't sound so bad.
Oh, I thought it'd be great at first, but then it turned out to be very unusual.
Unusual why?
Well, it's just that I thought they'd be, you know...
You thought they'd be what?
It's just that I thought they'd be...
You thought they'd be what?
It's just that I thought they'd be perfect.
Perfect?
Well, you know, with her being the principal and all, and the principal's husband, and the principal's kids, it's just that I thought they'd be, you know, perfect.
Are you saying they weren't?
I'm saying they weren't even close.
Not close? Why? What happened?
Well, it's just that I was sitting on top of the tree, no business, doing what treetop angels do, basically nothing, when all of a sudden Miss Shaver decided that I needed to be adjusted.
Oh, I hate when that happens.
But that's not the point. The problem was she told Mr. Shaver to help her because she couldn't reach me.
So, what did he say?
He said, babe, I'm a little tired, and actually, if you could just fix me a soda and a sandwich, that'd be great. Then, actually, I think I'll take a nap, and maybe I'll feel up to helping you fix that injury when I wake up.
No.
You should have seen the look on her face. It was eerie.
So, what'd she do then?
She stomped, and I do mean stomped, out to the kitchen, slapped together a sandwich, popped the top on a can of soda, stomped back out to the room, and Mr. Shaver was just sitting there, staring at the TV. She slammed that stuff down on the coffee table, and she said, don't worry about me, honey. I can fix that angel all by myself.
Wow, I didn't ever think a principal's wife would ever get mad at her husband.
Me either, but it gets worse.
No.
Oh, yeah. She came back into the living room with a broom and swatted at me on top of the tree, and I went flying across the room and smashed into the wall.
Oh no, did Mr. Shavers say anything?
Well, when I went flying by, he yelled, "Get out of my way, I can't see the TV!" Well, actually, I didn't leave just then, not until...
Until what?
Until Mr. Shaver realized he made a big mistake, and he went to apologize to Ms. Shaver, and then they got all mushy. And then Miss Shaver went to get a hot glue gun to hot glue this thing to my spine. Have you ever had a tube hot glued to your spine?
No.
Me neither, and I'm not about to either. I ran for the door. Wait, what in the world is that?
I have no idea, but look at her. She sure doesn't look like one of us.
Hey, you, who are you? You're not by any chance a treetop angel, are you?
Oh no, but that's my dream. I hope the next year I can get a job as a treetop angel and spread peace and love all over the world. I hope that whoever sees me will see my gentle, loving spirit. They will love one another, help one another, and reach out to one another, all because they have been inspired by me and the love I have for the entire world.
What was that all about? Peace in the world? Yeah, right. That's a good one. Who does she think she is, Miss Universe?
Right, and everybody is just going to love each other to death. Yeah, right. That's a hoot. Wait, I think I hear Bubba coming.
No, Gabby, he's not here, I promise.
I bet Miss Little Peace of the World has never been pelted by a giant bag of gummy bears.
Yeah, Little Miss, everybody's just gonna love one another needs to realize that this Christmas thing is just another job and nothing else. It's only a job.
Exactly, it's only a job.
I come from the cold, stormy north with the rush to the war, I hurry forward. I toss from the trees, dead leaves down, the withered leaves all sere and brown. I sway the branches to and far, as on my way I whirl and go. I make it, by crack and crevice I slip in, and make a lively sounding din. Swift I come and swift away, with you I can no longer stay. For I am wanted elsewhere now, and so goodbye, I make my bow. Breathe upon these streams, they seize their murmuring and are at peace. Upon each window pane I trace, defiance filling glistening lace. Each boy and girl, 'tis plain to see, hath still a welcome home. Now snow, who is my guardian sweet, will all my young friends fondly greet.
Unsightly place, touched a shimmering radiance bright in the moonbeam's mellow light. By my brother Frost, for we both go hand in hand, you see. North wind goes gaily with us both, to help us he is nothing loath. And he and frost and rain combine to give us sweat in the clear sunshine, shimmer sparkling, pure and nice, transparent white and glistening ice.
I rust on mighty snow. I weave a gleaming covering for lakes and snow. They know that all must cease their murmuring when frost and I appear, for we will hold them, firm and fast. As long as we are here, gleaming, sparkling. Yet, pure and clear, bright, you'll find me neath a silver green.
each crispy fresh winter night.
Whoa, my children, here I am. I've sought you everywhere. And now to busy the work away, for you must all prepare to do your duties while I hold. And check your enemy, the great brown sun, with those rays with you. My children disagree. Now up away, wind to the west, and come again in glee. And join with frost, snow, and ice in one grand jubilee. And paint the cheeks with roses of all these children who ride through his sleep will run and shout. My children dear, with you, away to work, you must not shrink. Your duties dear, and now, to these your firmest friends, make each your most engaging vow.
Okay, so while we wait, we have one last performance, but I have a few more awesome jokes for you. I know y'all were waiting for me, so here we go. Why didn't the skeleton go to the Christmas party? He had nobody to go with. Yeah, that was good. I know, you can tell that one, how to drive that one. Okay, one last one here, and this is kind of because I'm a sports guy. What is Santa's favorite Olympic event? North Pole vault. Okay, well, that was the buzzkill. Hey, here we go.